Hello, my name is Christian Water from TradeVola, and we would like to talk today about penny stocks because from the previous video what we made or what we uploaded here on YouTube, there are a lot of questions or comments, and I think it's a good topic to talk again about penny stocks. I brought you a few examples. I think one of the best examples I opened at the beginning. The symbol of this stock is just put it here, is USW. I think all penny stocks are now with the W at the end, but I think this symbol is quite interesting because it shows mainly all the facts what I need for an interesting penny stock trade. We have a great increasement of the volume, and the volume, as you can see here, is 1.8 million per day, but for a penny stock is it's quite good. I think minimum should be 100,000 shares per day, because you don't have to forget, if you buy 1 million of this penny stock and it goes down and there's not enough volume or liquidity in this penny stock, you might cause bigger losses than with a smaller size. Then the volume is very important to enter or exit with a bigger size. That's why you should always take care that there's not only an increasement in the volume, that there's also a general good average volume. And I think this penny stock shows the volume is quite okay. So the first thing was volume. Second, we have here, it was like 3-4 cents what this penny stock, what was the price of this penny stock. And if you can see, what is the risk when I buy a penny stock for 3 cents? I can't lose more than this 3 cents. So this is my maximum risk. On the other hand side, 3 or 4 days ago, we reached here the highest level of 60 cents. I mean, you will normally not reach the best exit for sure. But what I also recommend, if you're trading penny stocks, and we can make a really simple example, maybe we calculated with 5 cents, because you also pay commission depending on your broker, might be like 1 cent per share. Of course, there's always a maximum, even if you pay like just a 0.5 cent per share and you buy 1 million shares, you will not pay 1 million multiplied by 0.5 cent. You will always have normally at every broker a maximum fee. This is something for all penny stock traders what you should double check in the beginning. If there's a per share fee, ask always for the maximum fee. If there's no maximum fee, you should maybe consider to change your broker. Best for penny stocks, of course, is a flat fee. A fixed price is always a good idea. But let's stay on this 10,000 shares. 10,000 shares multiplied by 5 cents. Then we speak about an investment of $500. And this $500 is your maximum loss. So for example, the stock moves up in a few days here up to 10 or 20 cents. I'm sorry, this was 15 cents. So 15 cents means you made 200% profit. And if you sell, let's say, half of this position, like 5,000 shares multiplied by these 15 cents what we discussed, then you will have here $750. So only by selling half of your position, you made a profit of $250. But on the other hand side, because this is the biggest issue normally, what everyone has is the exit. And you can still leave 5,000 shares of your position, because you already generated a profit of $250. And even if it's going down back to zero, you will not make a loss. So to make like only to sell like half of your position is always a good idea. As soon as you reach 100% by default, you will have no loss. You're like break even, and then you can leave this penny stock maybe for a few weeks, for a few months to generate a bigger profit if it's going up. So you should always consider these if we are speaking about penny stocks. But I also want to present you some more interesting penny stocks from the last few weeks. There's nothing really significant what we can talk about today. I just want to give you some examples what might be a bad example, or what might be an example what's not so good if it's going too fast in one day. Like here, there was a stock from 5 cents what went up to $2 to more than $2.60. This stock, even with this volume, this was a few thousand percent in one day. This is, I think, a little bit too big, but even here you can wait a few days and see if it's the volume still stays on a high level, if there's still maybe a new movement what came here. Also with a new volume, you can't just see it here because this peak was so high that this small volume size will be not visible in this sense, but we can maybe show it a little bit better here. This was also like 600,000 in volume. We saw movement from 25 cents to 50 cents, so this always almost doubled in one day. But I also want to talk about this, like volume increase, small increase in price. These are like signals what I really like. Even the trend before was slightly going up. The price with 25 cents is also quite okay. If we consider always selling maybe half of your position when this stock moves up to 100%, you will sell exactly here half of your position size. You're still in profit. So this is, I think, even we know it now because we're looking at the past, is a perfect example how to manage a penny stock, or an idea how to manage your penny stock trade. I mean, there are so many different ways. We just want to give you a few ideas how to manage this. And to give you an example of the symbol, it's AIRTW. That's the symbol what we showed you here. The next one is, I think, from a biotech company. Of course, as the next step, we should also check the information what this company is doing. But here we have exactly the same volume increasement, super high. The stock went up from 10 cents to almost $1, so 1000% in 2 days. That's just too much in a too short period of time. But things like this small movement here, volume increase on the same volume increase, that's perfect. You can sell, buy it here for 20 cents. And it's the same example, 20 cents, you will double here at 40 cents after 3 days. You can sell half of your position and you can still leave the other half for the next few weeks. And this symbol here, like I said, is ONTX, and then the W always at the end, what shows you that we are talking about penny stocks. And the other one was LGHLW. Here it's different because we have also quite significant volume increase, 4.5 million. But what's interesting here, we had already a huge gap. The stock jumped from 15 cents to 45 cents. If this is happening as a stock and you can see first people are selling, then of course this should be not the best signal for entry. Another example is maybe here at the end of January, where it was just a small gap and the stock moved during the trading day, always a little bit up. And we are speaking here about like 35 cents as a possible entry price. And it's pretty much the same. After a few days, you will have here 100%. Sell half of the position, and still there's a good possibility that this stock might jump above the $1 level. $1, I think, as we always speak about penny stocks, the interesting level what many penny stocks might have problems to go over. But if you follow the chance risk ratio and how to set maybe your limit order and your maybe possible trading stop or normal stock, then I think penny stock, especially for small portfolios, a very interesting field how to invest. And the last example what I think from the movement is maybe one of the best, is here USWSW. It started at 5 cent, below 5 cent with 3 cents. Then there was a long period of time that moves between 10 and 15%, but we had everything what we need. We had volume increase, it stays on a high level, and then here the next big movement came a few weeks later with another volume increase. So what we see as a signal for possible entry is also important to check this for maybe exit the position in a loss or before it's going down much more, because if we can see like here, it's 3, 4, 5 days going down. On the same side, the volume is going down. It means people are not so interested in this anymore. Of course, you can leave it for a few months. These stocks can still come with some new news or some new volume increase. But if this happens for a few days, you should maybe consider to close this position, or at least to make maybe a stop order at a certain level where you know, of course, if this happens, I would close the position and then better invest in some new penny stock. And what's also important to know with a penny stock, if you're really looking for some high percentage movement, more than 100%, you don't need a good win-loss ratio. It doesn't mean that every second trade must be a winning trade. You just need to make sure that you really participate from a big movement. So you need trades of 300, 400, 500%, even if it's just half of your position, because this will cover possible loss of other penny stocks. And don't forget the penny stock, all the examples what we saw here, there was not a single movement down back to zero. So a maximum loss can happen, but the probability is also not quite high. And if you consider also some exit scenarios in a stop loss, you might have a good chance and a good performance with these penny stock trades. And if you want to know more about penny stocks, please subscribe to our channel. We will keep you updated with more interesting stuff in the next weeks. I wish you a good day and hope to see you soon. Thank you very much.